Hi, in this video, we will show you the annotation capabilities of this platform. So let's take an example of a vector annotation. So I do a get task. I'll be presented with an image, which is a satellite imagery here. And as you see, there are a lot of buildings and one of the classes to be annotated is a building. So I'll choose a class as building and the shape as rectangle. The other shapes available are polygon or a cuboid, or a point, or a polyline, or point group. So for this, the polygon, the box that is a rectangle is suitable. So I'll just mark a box around this building. And you can increase the opacity a little to clearly see what area is covered. And I just run this through our AI model. What happens next is it automatically detects all the similar objects that are in this image. Now I can take another class and another object and do the same. So let's say this is a class parking and run this through the model. And it detected a few more for the same class. So this is how the user is supposed to annotate all the buildings and parking lots and the roads available in this. So to draw a polygon, the user can choose polygon and another class. And let's take this road as an example. So in this case, we'll just draw continuous points around this. And save done. So this is the polygon. So this is how the road has been detected, and we can adjust it a bit if necessary. Now for every object that is annotated, you can also capture the attributes along with this. So for example, this building, what category building this is. Is it an apartment or a mall or a shop or a hospital? Let's say this is an apartment, and let's say this is a mall. And so on. So for each object annotated, you can capture its own attributes. Now we also support semantic segmentation on an input image. So what we saw was a vector annotation where you just capture the coordinates of the box of the objects. In case of semantic segmentation, you will just capture all the pixels that belong to an object. So let's take an example image of this car and the road and a pavement, and the objects to be annotated are the same. So let's take the car as an example and polygon as a shape. So we'll just draw a polygon around the car. It doesn't have to be very accurate because we have other ways to correct the incorrect shapes. So now as you see, it has mark all the pixels of this car within the polygon as the car. Now you can take a paintbrush to make some finer adjustments and increase the pixel size also. So let's say this area belongs to the car. You just drag around it. Even the top part. And here at the bottom. And in case you make a mistake like this, you need an eraser, which is this, and you can again use a paintbrush to erase the same area. So now the next task is if I have to mark all the pavement. So I choose the class as pavement, and we also have a superpixel tool which can do certain things faster in case of semantic segmentation. If you look at this, if I am going to click on this area, all these pixels within this area will be marked as this class. So I can show you an example. Click and drag and keep going. It marks. Now I can make this a little more coarser to detect a little bit more area in each clip. So now it detects a little more like this. So it will be a little faster. So all the pavement has been detected, but there is also a certain unwanted area that has been marked. So I use an eraser again, and I can use the same pixel super pixel tool with a little finer option, and I can erase this part using the same. Now all this will be erased much faster. So these are the different options available in case of semantic segmentation. Now finally, if you want to say the rest of the image belongs to a single class, let's say it's a road, and let's change the default to road, everything else will be marked as road. This is how we achieve 100% segmentation. Next, we'll move on to the OCR part of the image, where if you have a text on the image and you need to detect all the text available in the image. So the user's task is to draw a box around the text and write what the text actually is. But we run this through an AI model which automatically detects as much text as possible. So if you look at this image, if you click on this box, you'll see what text has been detected for this. Similarly, if you look at this Arabic part, even that has been detected. Let's take this as an example. And if you look at the text, it's not accurate. So what you can do is the user can just edit this and say what the actual data for this is. And for the next one, you can choose it again and say this is Al. This is the OCR part of it. You see accessories have been detected correctly, car has been detected, and so on. Next is, we also support another option in case of a vector annotation. So let's say this is an image that is we are supposed to annotate, and let's take a car as an example from this. As you can see, this is a park, all the cars are parked in one area. So these set of images were given from a video which converted all its frame to images, and the annotation needs to be performed on the images. So obviously we'll know all the images will have these parked cars with them, and there is no point in annotating them in every picture. So what we do is the user annotates all the objects in one image, and let's say he annotates these three cars, and then now he goes and submits this task and does a get next task. So he will be presented with an option to load the existing annotations. If I click on yes, as you can see, those cars have been annotated again. So the previous annotations will be copied over. So in this case, the only moving object is this person, which the user is supposed to annotate in every frame. Rest of them will remain the same. That is one more advantage that comes along with the configuration. And next one, we can move on to a geotagging, which is the same annotation on a satellite imagery. But instead of just drawing the boxes, here we will actually capture the coordinates of the object. The advantage here is we can lay the OpenStreetMap on the actual image that is provided. If you click on the base, you can look at the image that is actually provided of this area. You can zoom in and look at what it actually is. Or you can just switch to the OpenStreetMap, which gives you the same area for the coordinates. And it also gives you certain pre-annotated data. The user can click on fit to bound to see what area is he supposed to annotate, because an image contains a lot of area and it's not ideal for one user to annotate the entire area. So we kind of split it among different users and give only a certain area for a user to annotate. So in this case, if the user zooms in to this view, he'll see a lot of buildings here. And if he switches to the base view, he'll see the same even here. So there is also a lot of pre-annotated data which is not so very accurate. So the user can just click on this and start editing this. Or if we find a new building which is not pre-annotated, we can choose a new shape as polygon and a new build class as building, and we can draw a polygon around this. So this belong becomes a new building now. This is how the user can annotate. Next use case is LiDAR. So here the input is an image and also all the LiDAR points, that is the points that is detected by the LiDAR device. So if you look at this image, it is taken from the angle that is presented here by two lines. So this is the camera angle, and you can drag the LiDAR data and zoom in to whichever object you want. So if I take this car as an example and start drawing a box around this object, as soon as I draw this, you can see the box is drawn on this car. And I can also adjust the top view or the side view from these options. This is the top view and this is the side view. To annotate, this one will be used to adjust the height of the car. And I can choose the next object that I want and draw a box around that. So I just need to go to the draw mode and choose another car and draw a box. The next feature is video annotation. The user does a get task and he'll receive a video to annotate. So if you look at this, this video has 520 frames. Either the user can play through the video or go frame by frame. So the classes to be annotated are cars and vans. So I'll choose a car and a rectangle as a shape. I'll draw a box around this car, for example, and I can just run this through our AI model, and this will get the traffic tracking information of this car in the entire video. So now if I just play through the video, I should be able to see the car being tracked by this box. I can pause and come back to the beginning, and I decide to track a van as well in this video. So I'll mark a box around this van, run this as well through the model, and play through the video again. See, both the objects will be tracked throughout the video. You can pause at any stage and start capturing another car in a box this way. So this is the capability of video annotation.